what mosques need to be doing to engage their community in Ramadan, inshallah. So let's go. The first of the three C's is to collaborate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells in the Quran, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 2, that Allah encourages us to work together in our communities. And mashallah, we have so many masajid, so many mosques in one area, sometimes one on every other street. Many of you have already grouped together and you're already collaborating for the benefit of engaging your local council. And you've had some amazing, amazing results. For example, having the adhan performed out loud, or having parking restrictions eased for Jummah and Eid. Or some councils of mosques, mashallah, have been able to collaborate and organize professional counseling services to be available to their musallis via the mosques. These are amazing efforts. And now is the time for us to collaborate, regardless of whether you're in a council, even if you're just two or three mosques together, to deliver a truly transformative Ramadan for the entire community, not just your select few musallis. So for example, many of you may be thinking of a getting ready for Ramadan type program, but by working together, we don't need, you know, in one community, 16 different getting ready for Ramadan programs. Collaborate, work together and deliver one program where all of your different imams and speakers will come together like we're doing tonight, but that benefits the whole of your community. And mashallah, we saw in Ramadan last year, so many programs from all of you. But what ended up happening for us, the recipients, is that there's too much noise, too many choices, too many live streams, too many programs. But by collaborating, by working together, by offering something truly transformative, inshallah, not doing the same as the mosque next door to you, you can bring real value to your community. Which brings me to my next point, the second of the three C's, which is for you to communicate and be available, alhamdulillah. Since Ramadan last year, many of you have been taking the steps to take your mosque digital. But now is the time to take your communication to the next level and really engage and build your contacts, build your database, build your mailing list, inshallah. By now, you should be aiming to post and cross-post your updates and announcements daily across all your different platforms, whether that's Facebook, Telegram, email, text messages, etc. You should aim to be posting daily for your community. And be posting in a place that people can engage with you. They can reply to you. They can comment. They can give you a thumbs up. Post even if you have nothing to update your community about. For example, if rice is on sale at your local grocery store, you should tell your community. Even if it's nothing, build that relationship, build that communication with your community, inshallah. Many of you, mashallah, have receivers that you turn on just to do the adhan and for the salah. You have that facility, those receivers are in people's homes. Why not turn your receiver into a Quran radio station? And this is where we start to build real relationships with our community, inshallah. And don't fall for the live streaming trap. They say that when you go online, you're meant to reach more people. But when we look at the statistics of all the different live streams, we're not reaching as many people as we could. And that comes with building a real connection with them. And building a connection with them is our community, the final one of the three C's, inshallah. This is something that I really hope everyone can understand, is don't worry about the numbers. And the best way to think about this is just think about one family that you're communicating with. Think about what they've been through since last Ramadan. You know, the parents are stressed out. Maybe the father's been working from home or the mother's been working from home. You know, the kids have been doing school online. There've been no socializing. There've been no, you know, recreational activities. This Ramadan is your opportunity as community leaders to build your content collaboratively with other masjids for that one family. Focus on that one family. But with any program, you know, any program we do, whether it's work or whatever it may be, we always need to know how effective it is. And you need to measure it. You need to know whether you've had an impact, a beneficial impact on your community. And this is where we need to shift our attention and our focus from broadcasting it live via Facebook or YouTube or via your receiver into having people register for your program. Yes. Why would you do that? So that, just like we're doing right now, you can engage with them, they can leave comments, they can leave thumbs up, ask you questions, and you can track their progress and their understanding just like we are right now on Zoom. And mashallah, there are 64 of you here listening to me right now. You are a captive audience. I can see all of your names. I can engage on you. I can pick on you all individually. You can't do that as well on a live stream, inshallah. So what live streams are good for, though, is for bringing people into your ecosystem and making them aware of your programs. So to conclude, this has been a whistle-stop tour of something that we're calling lockdown fatigue, how to engage your community this Ramadan. So inshallah, on Saturday, 13th of March, in the afternoon, we're going to be doing a program where we'll go through these three C's and more in much more detail, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.